Hello Aries, how are you? Welcome to my channel Star 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 and welcome to your reading. So Aries, this is your reading for the month of October 2021 and this is a general reading. Take what resonates and leave what doesn't. Energies might be vice versa and time is fluid. Okay, Aries, I would appreciate if you would hit like, share and subscribe and comment down below if you find yourself getting resonated with this reading. I would also request you to hit that notification bell so that you will be notified whenever I upload the videos. Aries, I'm going to see what's going on in your love life. Okay, what is your energy? What is the energy of your person? What are the mutual energies between you and that you and your person? Okay, then we'll see what is coming up for you in your love life and what is coming up for you in your finances and your career. Okay, so let's get started now. Sun, lovers and magician for you, three of swords, then six of wands and two of cups for your person, page of pentacles and five of wands as a mutual energy. So now let's see what is next that is coming up in your love life. What is the next chapter that is coming up in your love life? What is next that is coming up in your love life? Two of wands, then we have is the high priestess and we have six of swords. Okay, what next is coming up in your career and your finances? What next is coming up in your career and your finances, Aries? What next is coming up in your career and your finances? Temperance, nine of swords and empress. Interesting. So let's talk about your current love life situation. So you may be dealing with a Leo, you may be dealing with a Gemini. Gemini is standing out strong with lovers and magician. You may be dealing with a Virgo. Okay, Aries, Leo, Sag, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Okay, yes, Virgo and Scorpio is what I'm hearing. If the sign pops up, all the better. Let's not remain fixed on the signs, okay? So we have Sun, lovers and the magician. This is for you. So Aries, what I feel is that maybe the previous situation was sort of a burden for you, okay? You have learned a couple of things about yourself. You have learned a couple of things about what you value the most in a relationship, what you value the most about yourself. And one of the factors that is standing out is freedom. Okay? One of the factors that is standing out is you want things to flow with their natural course of action. Okay? You don't want a situation to happen in your life which sort of comes across as a burden for you or for the other person. Okay, things should unfold naturally. Things should take or proceed as per their natural course of action. Okay, and the relationship should not be felt like a burden for you or the other person. So this was probably the biggest lesson for you. You thought that you loved someone and probably, yes, there was love for some other person. But at the same time, you also felt like you had lost yourself somewhere in the process. You were no more yourself. Okay? You were probably the one who was always compromising or surrendering to the whims and fancies of the other person. Okay, you felt like you were not only losing the freedom, but you were also losing yourself in the process. And that was the biggest and the biggest red flag for you. Okay, it sort of probably scared you that, oh, I cannot afford to lose myself. Okay, So that was the biggest red flag for you in this journey. Okay, what I'm sensing is your love relationships are you know, whatever learning lessons you have had in your life, major learning lessons, those learning lessons have come through your love relationships. Okay, yes, you have learned a lot of things in the other domain, in other domains of your life also, like your career, your other relationships with friends and all that stuff. Okay, but what I see is the major lessons, major realizations have come through love relationships. Okay, with that lovers, Aries, I feel that, okay, with the lovers and the sun card next to one another, what I feel is you are sensing intuitively, or you know that a better future is awaiting for you. Okay, either you are feeling that intuitively, or you are extremely optimistic and positive about your love life. You are positive and optimistic is because, yes, you are feeling something from inside. Okay, love life is about to bloom very soon. You are about to meet someone, or you have already met someone, Aries. Who you think is an equal match for you, with whom you can envision a long-term future. Okay, you are having a lot of love for this person, or you will have a lot of love for this person whenever you will meet them. Okay, and the moment you see this person, you'll have an instant attraction, instant connection with them. Okay, it will be an unexplained connection, but I'm also sensing that this is a sort of a fated relationship, and you have experienced a lot of synchronicities, and or rather you will experience a lot of synchronicities whenever you will meet them. Your person will also experience a lot of synchronicities, like you may see angelic numbers, you may just feel like, no, I should do certain things right now only. Okay, so you'll be called to do certain things when the time to meet your person is quite nearby, or you may have experienced whatever I'm saying right now, you may have experienced that already when you met your person. Okay, say for example, very very nominal things, okay, but they make a big difference. Say the person that you're going to meet, okay, if they like a specific color, if they like yellow color dress or whatever, okay, and you are the one who usually doesn't like wearing yellow color dresses, but if the day when you're going to meet your person, you probably maybe automatically feel like, oh no, maybe I've not tried this yellow color shirt since a very long time, maybe I should wear that, and you're going to wear that and you're going to step out and you will meet your person accidentally. So this, something like this is, I'm just giving you an example, there may be a lot of other things also. Okay, like probably you'll cancel last minute plans and you'll do something else, and then you're going to meet this person. Okay, so certain things will automatically happen, or you will feel like you're being called to do those things. Okay, so you are going to experience a lot of synchronicities when you're going to meet this person, and I'm sensing, Aries, the time is quite nearby. Okay, for some of you, I feel you have already met your person. With that magician, I feel don't be surprised if you're going to meet this person, because you are the one who is strongly manifesting this person. Okay, whether you know that, you don't know that, consciously, subconsciously, you're manifesting this person in your life, and you're underestimating your power, Aries. Okay, you are a very good manifester. You are coming across as a magician. Okay, you know how to use your tools and your resources. Some of you probably you're exploring your psychic abilities of late, you have started noticing, like, whoa, even I have these psychic abilities, even I have some strong intuitions. Or maybe you used to get intuitive downloads in the past, but you never paid attention to that. Nowadays you have started paying attention. Okay, so you are an amazing manifester. Okay, if you have manifested a certain level of success in your life, it is because of your psychic abilities, your hard work, your determination, plus there is a lot of manifestation that is going on. Okay, when you set your eyes on something, your subconscious mind keeps on chasing that, whether it is a situation, whether it is a person, your subconscious mind keeps on chasing that situation or a person. Okay, whether you know it or you don't know it. And that's what I feel, this new person that is going to enter in your life, you have manifested that person, Aries. Okay, as far as your person is concerned, Two of Cups we have is Six of Wands and we have Three of Swords. This person, they are realizing that they committed a mistake. Okay, this person, your past person, they have realized that they have committed a mistake. They have realized that they have sabotaged a beautiful situation. Okay, they have absolutely realized that a situation which was extremely beautiful, which was extremely fulfilling and satisfying, they are responsible for sabotaging the situation, and they are feeling bad. They are feeling bad about it. Okay, but the problem over here is the hurt and the pain is so much. This person gave you so much of hurt and pain that you have to do a lot of things to heal yourself from that pain. Okay, the pain is still there. It is still there. You are a powerful soul, so you know how to numb the pain. You know how to laugh even when you have a lot of pain inside you. Okay, you may be showing to the world like, yes, I am good, I am all right, I'm doing good for myself. Okay, but inside there is a storm that is going on, which is taking some time to calm down. Okay, and what I feel is that your past person is feeling bad that they caused you so much of pain. Okay, that they caused you so much of hurt. They want to come towards you. They may come towards you with an apology, or they may have already come towards you with an apology with that Two of Cups. They may say that, I still like you, I still love you, okay, I still think about you, and is there anything that we can do to reunite, to reconcile? But the problem over here is, maybe what I feel is, the trust which was there in this relationship, it's gone. Okay, the trust is gone, and now you fear going back because you fear that this person may butcher your heart all over again, and you don't want to end up in that situation. Okay, because you have suffered a lot and you don't want to suffer all over again. You have feelings for this person, you do have feelings for this person, but having feelings and suffering pain because you are having feelings is totally different. They are two extreme emotions, and exactly opposite emotions, I'll say. Okay, and the trust is gone, and trust is replaced by fear, trust is replaced by pain, okay, which you don't want to experience all over again. Mutual energy is out of Page of Pentacles and Five of Wands. So, what I feel is, very soon you have some internal conflict. Look, you have some internal conflict that is going inside you. Okay? And the conflict is around, maybe a new person that is coming in your life, or that is already present in your life. It's like you're going back and forth, Aries. Okay, you like this person, you love this person, but then you also think about the past person, because there was a big arrangement, there was a big setup with the past person, and yes, it's not impossible to get out of that setup, but it is a bit difficult to get out of that setup emotionally. But yes, you're trying hard. Okay, what I feel is that ultimately with that Page of Pentacles, you will proceed with your new love, because you are sensing that you are healing yourself from this pain because of the new love that will happen, or that is going to happen in your life. The new person is going to help you heal from this pain that you're suffering right now. Okay, pain that you're going through right now. So let's see now what is coming up next in your love life. I hope this resonates. Hit like, share, and subscribe, and comment down below. Two of Wands, High Priestess, and Six of Swords. What is coming up next? A decision needs to be made. You're being asked to make a decision. Yeah, I told you, right? There is some... You're going a bit back and forth. You're being asked to make a decision because there is going to be an entry of a new person in your life very soon. I'm also sensing that some relocation is there in this process. Someone is getting relocated. You and this new person, both of you are divided by a water body probably. Okay. Either you are getting relocated to this new person's place, or they are getting relocated at your place. A relocation is happening pretty soon, Aries. Okay. And what I feel is that, especially in year 2022, things are going to move pretty, pretty fast between you and this new person. The only thing that is required is you need to make a decision. Once you make that decision, things are going to escalate very fast between you and this new person. Very fast. Some relocation is happening. There is some relevance of a water body over here. Either both of you are divided by a huge water body in between, or someone has a house facing the ocean or the sea or a river, or someone wants to have a home like that, or maybe someone has a strong presence of water in their chart. Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, Saturn. Someone has Scorpio, Saturn over here. Someone is. Alright. So, as far as your money and your finances are concerned, it's looking awesome. Let me tell you that. You have certain worries around your finances. But don't worry. You are rising up. You are rising up. And especially with the Temperance card, what I feel is you're protected. Okay. So, if you are worried about certain things, don't worry. Know that you're protected. Secondly, what I feel is that someone is going to be lucky for you. Okay, someone is lucky for you, because in spite of going through this, we have an immediate next card as the Empress. So even if you are worried like this because of some bad situations that are happening as far as money and your career is concerned, it is instantly going to change, because someone's luck is going to help you change that. Someone is lucky for you. Maybe at a workplace, your boss is changing, or maybe, yeah, this new person who is entering in your life, this person is lucky for you. Or maybe, your planetary positions may change. But what I see is that there is going to be a sudden change. From feeling worried and stressed out, you are going to feel a lot abundant and a lot relaxed. Okay? The much needed stability is going to come as far as your career, your money, and your finances are concerned. Okay, all right. I hope this resonates. Hit like, share, and subscribe, and comment down below. Till then, bye bye.